big mysteries to me has always been, in Middle Woodland times, from about 200 BC to about 400 or 500 AD, you have this cultural expression of the Ohio Hopewell, where they build the giant geometric earthworks and the great serpent mound and large conical burial mounds. Why, you know, there doesn't seem to be readily apparent in the archaeological record, maybe other than conical mounds and maybe short linear mounds, a continuation of the expression of that cultural manifestation into this mound building manifestation. And one of the early archaeologists that really influenced me was Bob Hall, who recently passed away a few years ago. And I was very fortunate to sit down and have numerous conversations with him in person, over the phone, and through email over the course of the latter part of his life, where, you know, his big thing was that he used to try to look at the archaeological record and try to explain what we see in the archaeological record and relate that back to the myths and legends and the stories of native peoples. And in archaeology, well, and we call that like deep meaning or deep theory, where he is looking at things that are occurring in the archaeological record and applying that back to the myths and legends, or and vice versa. And what his contention always was is that you couldn't have had a nearly 3,000 year period, 2,500 year period of mound construction ritualism that wouldn't have survived or been expressed in the continuing stories and myths and legends. And, you know, how do these things progress? You know, they start off building, we think in Wisconsin, building large conical burial mounds in the early woodland period, about 800 to 500 BC. Then we think that there is a period of these small, short linear cigar-shaped burials like this one right over here. And then they do that for about 1,000 years. And then right around 500 to 700 AD or so, give or take, they start to build effigies. And they start building those in and amongst mound sites that are even ancient to them by 1,000 years in some cases. So there's this continuation of the use of sacred space, the recognition of that sacred space. And it's always kind of confused me a little bit about why that Hopewell manifestation kind of died out around 400 AD. Then there seems to be maybe a couple of centuries of no mound building. I shouldn't say no mound building. There probably were continuing to build mounds, and radiocarbon dates are, you know, fluctuate on the plus or minus side. But it really isn't until about 650, 700 AD that they start to do the effigy mounds. So what was the carryover from Middle Woodland times, if there was any, to the Late Woodland period in this ritualism? You know, you have that the one great serpent mound in near Peebles, Ohio, about 70 miles east of Cincinnati, the giant serpent effigy. And then you have another effigy, a seemingly effigy mound, two other seemingly effigy mounds. One is the tailed mound in Ohio. And then you have another site that's called the Tremper site that seems to show one effigy that seems to look like a bear. And then at Newark, you have an effigy of a bird that is in a short wing kind of bird mound that's in the middle of a Hopewell enclosure. But otherwise, you don't have any other effigies that extend beyond northern Illinois, around the bottom of the Great Lakes, into the Ohio River Valley. They all concentrate right here in Wisconsin, southern third of Wisconsin, northeastern Iowa, southeastern Minnesota, and parts of northern Illinois. So I don't know. I've asked several other archaeologists that are very knowledgeable about mound building cultures about, was there any carryover from Middle Woodland to effigy mounds? And I've never really been able to find that answer out. Some people believe that there was like this mini dark age where they, you know, after the Ohio Hopewell went on the demise, they didn't build mounds for a couple centuries, and then all of a sudden they started building effigies in this region. Now, whether that was directly influenced to Ohio building, I don't know. I haven't seen any reports or any kind of written literature that talks about correlation to that. But what I did was I started to look at the actual excavation reports and the inner workings about what we know about mounds and the possible continuation of ritualism that you see associated inside mounds from early and middle woodland times and how that might have carried over into effigies. And in some cases you see the use of special soils, the use of stones for altars, red ochre, which is not so much an effigy mound use, but you do see it in middle woodland and early woodland mound construction in some cases. So the continuation of inner workings of ritualism seem to continue in some aspects, but in some other aspects it doesn't. In early, middle woodland mound construction, they tend to have more elaborate burials with grave goods, certain types of exotic lithic materials, shell material, obsidian, mica, copper, things like that. But when you get into the late woodland effigy mound construction, they're virtually devoid of grave goods. In some cases, you'll find pottery in some cases, late woodland Madison and Prest pottery. In some cases, you'll find maybe a biface or an arrowhead. But for the most part, effigy mounds didn't seem to contain grave goods. And there wasn't any differentiation between male, female, child. Some cases you had multiple burials, some cases singular burials. Oftentimes burials are contained in the middle parts of the mounds or the areas of the mounds that were considered the heart region of the effigy as it's in plain view. In some cases, that's not the case. And in some cases, effigy mounds were built that didn't seem to contain burials. And what that tells me is that the ritualism of actually building the effigy mound was just as important as actually building the mound for burial purposes. And you know, a lot of times when avocational folks come on mound sites that are not as knowledgeable about mound sites, they kind of have this built-up assumption, they have built-up assumptions about mound sites that these mounds were all built in one large mound building episode, but that wasn't the case. These are places that were, you know, visited over successive generations and added to for very specific reasons. And even though the mounds seem to have kind of a random placement, there very much was an intentional placement of mounds in these mound sites. And we don't entirely understand what that meaning of the placement was. But there's a lot of different people looking at that, ideas and theories about that, astronomical, celestial, you know, things of that nature.